has played 4 years of basketball at SDHS, 2 years on the varsity. She would like to thank her father for always practicing and shooting with her on the weekends, her mother for cooking her wonderful meals after practice, her team, which she loves and admires for being so encouraging, and she is very proud of watching you all grow up because of the beautiful player you are. She would also like to thank God for always being supportive, helping her get closer to the game with creating high fives, and she for being a consistent goal in her life, pushing her to make her better. She'll never forget when basketball has started, and she is very grateful about spending her high school years as part of such a special program. Her favorite memory is traveling to Arizona this year with the team and when they beat Marine Corps. Her previous plans were to attend a four-year college, majoring in business management and marketing.
Number four, Audrey King.
Thank you.
As a senior parent, we want to acknowledge the effort of her tireless commitment to supporting student athletes. We have been supporting your children, inspiring, leading, mentoring, encouraging, and believing in the athletes that are part of the program. The coach is not ready to be a mentor as a facility of inspiring athletes, confidence, resiliency, leadership, and desire to succeed on and off the court. The world of legendary Siena, the new chapter of both academics, committing to seniors and them all are being part of the family. It comes with obligations, commitments, and education goals. But there's a reward for learning cost. Thank you for being a part of our family.
There you have the senior night festivities. The teams will get their warm-ups, and we will bring you the action live here in Pfeiffer Gym.
This broadcast is sponsored in part by
The Schoen Group, located in beautiful downtown Sonoma. The Schoen Group is affiliated with Sotheby's International Realty. Our goal is to be your realtor consultants and representatives for many generations to come. For information and guidance regarding Wine Country Real Estate, you may contact us at 707-933-1515 or visit schoengroup.com. Underwriting is provided by Sonoma Paint Center, located at 815 West Napa Street. For more information, you can go to sonomapaintcenter.com.
Being brought to you in part by Myers Financial, located at 670 West Napa Street, Suite C. For more information, you can go to myersfinancial.com.
Every single chain, even when I'm in the house. Down everything, setting rolls gone. tell me that you're modern if you ain't been involved. Gotta throw a party for my day ones. Banging in the studio with their Renaissance. Rest in peace to Drama King.
Are we ready, Juan? We are live here in Pfeiffer Gym. It's senior night for the Lady Dragon varsity basketball team. Big game for them as they control their own destiny. A win tonight against their rivals, the Justin Siena Braves, and a win Tuesday night at Casa Grande. They would be the outright Vine Valley Athletic League champions. There's scenarios, all sorts of scenarios for a three-way tie, Casa Grande outright, Sonoma outright, just all sorts of different scenarios of the Vine Valley League. It's been like that all year, very competitive league. Sonoma honored their seniors Lola Martin, Catherine Uoz, Audrey King, and they honored the Justin seniors Mary Hune, Bella Balmaceda, Emery Messenger, Hannah Spare, and Megan Jackson. Getting ready to do the starting lineups for both teams, and we will be tipping this game off. Sonoma Valley comes to the contest 8-2 on the season. Justin Siena 5-5. Those are league numbers. Sonoma overall is 19-5. Justin Siena 11-2.
Please help us to promote the ideal of good sportsmanship and competition. You can show your support best by extending your courtesy towards the player, staff, fans, and officials. Thank you for making this a positive experience for everyone involved. Now the starting lineup for the Justin Siena Braves, announced by head coach Andrew Betancourt. Senior number 10, Mary Hune.
Yep.
Senior number 11, Bella Palmaceda. Senior number 13, Emery Messenger.
Right about there.
Sophomore number 23, Jordan Washington. And freshman number 33, Lauren Stellar. And now the Lady Siena.
Thank you.
Sonoma starting all three of their seniors tonight. Usually Juhas is the first person off the bench. They like to do that where they can get Wilkins and then her on the court and then both of them together, mix them up, and we'll be doing the national anthem and get this ball rolling. Senior Sam Cutting had his senior night last night for the Sonoma basketball team, doing the national anthem on the electric guitar, and we're getting ready for the tip. Two arch rivals here. The league is at its inception. Just been a great, fierce, but friendly rivalry between these two squads, only 13 miles apart. Justin travels well, and a lot of their school goes there from Sonoma, so easy to be here. Got a great crowd here on the Dragon side of the court. Lola Martin doing the tip. 32 points, 18 rebounds on Thursday night in the overtime victory over American Canyon with a school record 8 three-pointers, and she'll win the tip over to Juhas. Got it over and back, though, as it was knocked back into the backcourt. And he'll turn over to Justin Siena, who in the captain for the Braves, senior point guard. You're going to get Martin with a little push off the bat, a little different than Thursday night's game where they kind of let him go a little bit. Talked about Martin's 32 points, 8 threes, and she had one that we thought was a three, but her tippy toe was on the line, and 8 threes on the night, but just a huge night for the Dragons. Knocked away by Juhas, over to Martin, and Hoban will bring it up. Justin does have a lot of height in their lineups. King gets it inside to Juhas, off to Martin, back to Juhas. Dragons are moving the ball real well. Get a little movement with the players. Cut to the basket. 8 seconds to shoot on the shot clock, and they'll kick it out to Juhas. Over to Martin, and she'll put up her three. And just like the other night, drains it. 3-0, Sonoma off the bat. Full court pressure by the defense, easily broken by Messenger. You got a push on the sideline by Hoban. And they're calling it pretty tight early here in this contest. You like the early fouls to be called more, you know, closer to the basket. Balmaceda with the ball. Give it back to Hewen. Covered by Hoban. Messenger with it. One of the seniors for Justin into Washington, and she'll kick it out the ball of Semeda. Tipped but recovered by Messenger. Washington with it, backs her person down, and it's blocked out of bounds to the Braves with only three to shoot. Washington, the senior for the Braves, a 6-foot sophomore, out to Balmaceda, and she's got to put it up. It's tipped away, and it's going to be a shot clock violation. Turnover to the Dragons. Great defense there by Sonoma Valley. Up 3-0 here early in this contest. Other games in the Vine Valley League tonight. Vintage at Napa at the big game. American Canyon in Petaluma. Cross court to Wilkins at the top. Over to King. She'll get a screen. Hoban with it. She'll drive. Kick it back out to Wilkins. And she'll put up a little set shot. No good. Huas hustles over and saves it. But Hoban can't keep it in the court. It'll go over to the Braves. Get it over to Keller, the freshman for the Braves out there. Boy, Hoban's just all over Hewen to start this contest. The loose ball will go to Balsameda. Shot's no good, rebounded by Wilkins. And Hoban will bring it up court. A lot of action so far tonight, but not too many points. You got a steal there for Balsameda. She's going to bring it up the court herself. The Dragons pick them up. Hewen will back it up. Start the offense for the Braves. Over to Keller. Covered by Martin. They're calling it super tight. Not much contact there, and fell after taking a step off of it. Inbound pass to Balsameda, and she'll put up the shot. No good. Tipped over to Martin. Still 3-0. 5 minutes left here in the first. Over to Hoban. Hoban, she'll put up the shot and drains it for two. It's put inside the line. 5-0 Dragons. Over to Balsameda, kicks it over to Hugh, and she's going to drive the basket, lay it up and in, and she's fouled. Just great atmosphere here in Pfeiffer Gym. Got two great fan bases. Presley Sorensen checking in the game. No, not yet. 3 throws no good. Lane violation on Sonoma. Hewen will get another free throw. And she makes that one. 5-3. Justin Siena coming up with their full court pressure. Balsameda on Hoban, a behind the back dribble over to Martin. Covered by Keller. Hoban with it. She'll drive at the corner. Get in into Juhas, and she's going to get fouled by Megan Jackson, who just checked into the game. Three team fouls on the Dragons. That's the first one on Justin. Over to Martin, sets up, and drains it again. Last two games, she has just been on fire from three-point land. Two already tonight. Keller with it. She'll back it out, get it to Balsameda. She'll drive to the hoop, lay it up, no good. Ball bouncing around. King comes out of it to Hoban on the break. Going to drive to the basket, raise it up and in. 10-3 Dragons, 3:50 left. Timeout, Justin. Coach Betancourt got to settle down his offense, and Sonoma playing some great defense and able to get a couple steals, a little fast break, easy layup there for two. 10-3 lead here in the first quarter. Yeah, the Vine Valley Athletic League basketball playoffs, where one plays four, two plays three, the winners play for the championship, are being held this year at Casa Grande High School. I believe the girls play on Thursday. They don't know what time yet. And the boys part of the league will play on Friday, and both championship games will be Saturday night at Casa Grande. There's that pressure again for the Dragons. Presley Sorensen into the game for the Dragons. Messenger gets it over to Balsameda. Over to Keller. Gets it back out to Hune. Back to Keller. Gets a screen by Washington. A little give and go, but didn't see it. Balsameda kicks it over. There's the three-pointer up. No good. Jackson gets her own rebound. Hune's going to drive, stop, put it up and in. Full court pressure by the Braves. Tenacious defense by both teams. King will pick that up for the Dragons and get across the court. Picks up a screen by Juhas. Off of Sonoma's hip. Out of bounds to the Braves. Frenetic defensive play so far here early in the first half. Both teams. Full court presses. Hewen, little fake drive, stop, puts it up, no good. Rebounded by Martin, and she'll come away with it. Big battle for the ball there. It's going to be a think they might call a walk on it. Kelsey Bauer checking in the game for the Dragons. And Jeskin will inbound it. Hune will get it into Keller. Picked up by Bauer. She'll put it up off the glass for two. 10-7 as Justin will bring back. Just pressure defense. They get it into King. To Wilkins. She's going to bring it up. Gets it over to King. Cross court pass to Bauer, and the Dragons just got to settle down. They still got 17 to shoot as Sorensen will drive towards the basket. Gets knocked away. Out of bounds to the Dragons with 10 seconds to shoot. Got Messenger and Navina Jackson checking into the game for the Grizzlies. Got Sorensen, Juhas, Wilkins, Bauer, and King on the court for the Dragons. Six to shoot. Put it back out to Sorensen. She'll put up a long three. Rattles off the rim, no good. Boston. Hewen will sky for the rebound, bring it up herself. Little Euro step, comes up a little short. Out of bounds on the player that got the rebound down the bottom of the court. And you got a timeout, Sonoma. Action-packed first quarter here. 10-7, Dragons in the lead. I tell you, no matter what sport these two teams play against each other, you know, there's just lots of action on the court. Teams definitely want to beat each other. When Tony Albini and I have had the Justin baseball team, the Sonoma baseball team, Sonoma football, basketball, Justin's basketball team on, you know, we ask him, you know, what's the team you like to beat? And invariably, for Justin, it's Sonoma. For Sonoma, it's Justin. It's been a very friendly rivalry at that, but very intense. Justin will back off the press. Keller will meet Sorensen about three-quarter court. 1:53 left here in the first. Kind of extending their zone defense out a little by the Braves. Pass over to Bauer. Gets it over to Juhas, and she'll put it up. Rattles out. Rebounded by the Braves. And they're looking to run. Hewen gets the pass. Beautiful pass there. Partially blocked. The ball's battled around. Bowers comes up with the rebound. Hands it off to Sorensen. She'll set up a little jump shot and drains it. Had a real tough shooting night, Sorensen did on Thursday night. Nice to see her hit that shot there, and maybe that will open up the floodgates. Keller will get it across the half court lane. It'll spin around, covered by Bauer. Jackson will drive, off the rim, no good. Rebounded by Wilkins. And Sorensen's gonna have to hustle. The pass was just a little lazy pass there, away from Sorensen. Got Balsameda checking back into the game, replacing Kuhn. Get it into Megan Jackson. Got two of them out there. Number 22, Navina. Going to be off of the Dragons, out of bounds. 25 to shoot for the Braves. Keller inbound it. Gets it over to Balsameda. Swings it over to Navina Jackson. Kicks it out. Messenger, no good. Tipped away, rebounded by Sorensen. She'll bring it up. Picked up by Keller. Kicks it out to King, and she'll set up for three. A little strong, rebounded by Megan Jackson. Still 12-7. 30 seconds left here in the first quarter. Balsameda will bring it up. Going to go out of bounds. Possession will stay with the Braves. Now you got a blocking foul, actually, on the Dragons. Going to be on King. Her first of the night. Megan Jackson with it, driving towards the free throw line, will stop. Over to Keller. She'll drive to the basket, picked up by Bauer and King. They trap her over in the corner, tipped away, recovered by Navina Jackson, over to Balsameda. Think you got a little trip there. Two players going for the ball, and the legs just kind of went out from under them. Shot clock is off. 10 seconds left here in the first. Mia Lachetti will check into the game for the Dragons. Keller will drive to the basket, stop, put it up, blocked by the Dragons as the crowd goes crazy. Shot off the glass, no good. And that's going to be the end of the first quarter. To the light of the Sonoma crowd, Sonoma 12, Justin 6. We'll take a word from the sponsors and we'll be right back.
This broadcast is sponsored in part by
The Schoen Group, located in beautiful downtown Sonoma. The Schoen Group is affiliated with Sotheby's International Realty. Our goal is to be your realtor consultants and representatives for many generations to come. For information and guidance regarding wine country real estate, you may contact us at 707-933-1515 or visit schoengroup.com. Underwriting is provided by Sonoma Paint Center, located at 815 West Napa Street. For more information, you can go to sonomapaintcenter.com.
Being brought to you in part by Myers Financial, located at 670 West Napa Street, Suite C. For more information, you can go to myersfinancial.com.
This broadcast is...
A lot of defense here so far in Pfeiffer Gym. Big game for the Dragons as they look to, if they can take this game tonight, they'll be at least share the Vine Valley Athletic League title for the first time. Hoban gets it over to Sorensen. She takes a look, picked up by two Braves. Cross-court pass. And that's stolen by Hune, and she's going to take it up the court. And you got to travel. Sorensen and Martin got back there to pressure that one. And Hoban will bring the ball up to the court. Picked up by Hune. Nice pass to Bauer. Over to Sorensen, and she'll just set up shop and drains it again. Her second three of the night. 15-7 Dragons. Her and Martin both have 2 threes. Kuhn will set up the offense for the Braves, covered by Hogan. Dragons, man-to-man most of the time, little help there. Bauer with it. Jackson will stop, covered by two Dragons, a little reverse move. Lays it up, no good. Ball's loose, recovered by Kuhn. She's going to drive to the basket, blocked once again. Tipped away by Bowers. Megan Jackson will recover it. Balsameda, a little crossover dribble over to Megan Jackson. Dragons just playing super defense here all over the court as Bauer covers up Jackson. 8 seconds left to shoot. Balsameda gets it. She stepped out of bounds, I believe, and she did. Turnover because of the intense defense of the Dragons. Cross-court pass over to Sorensen, to Wilkins. Swing it over, nice ball movement by the Dragons. Get it over to Wilkins, she's gonna drive. Lays it up off the glass for two. Yes, the bank is open once again in Pfeiffer. You got the fans for Sonoma going crazy. 17-7 here early in the second quarter. Dragons just zipping that ball around the perimeter of the offense, you know, getting some cutters in there. And defensively, they're just playing super out there with their man-to-man defense. Next game for the Dragons will be Tuesday night at Casa Grande, which could be for all the marbles in the Sonoma Vine Valley, or the Vine Valley Athletic League, almost said the Sonoma County League like the old days. You know, possible Sonoma can win it outright. Possible Casa Grande can win it outright. There's combinations of both of those teams and American Canyon. And there's also the possibility of a three-way tie. Got Martin, Hoban, Sorensen, Bauer, and Wilkins out there for the Dragons. Got Navina Jackson, Jordan Washington, Kuhn, Balsameda, and Keller. Full court pressure, a little tip there, but Balsameda will get it. Kuhn over to Keller, and they'll beat the break. Picked up by Hoban. Sorensen on Kuhn, picks up a screen, will dribble, stop, inside to Washington, and that's going to be a charge, and it is. Tell you, it's senior night here with a huge crowd. This is the way it should be all the time for the basketball squads here at Pfeiffer. It really gives just such a big lift to the players. 17-7 here in the second. Cross court pass to Bauer, and she's going to just shoot it up. No good. Rebounded by Wilkins. Over to Martin. To Hoban. Swing it over to Sorensen. Got Martin open in the corner. Wilkins, nice move. She'll lay it off the glass. No good. Gets her own rebound, though. Taken away by Navina Jackson. As Justin's looking to run, Hewen will bring it up. Picked up by Sorensen. She'll have to set up the offense. Stolen by Bauer. They try to trap her, gets it over to Hoban. Gets a screen by Wilkins. Over, was give and go, but stolen. That's Keller with the steal over to Balsameda. Navina Jackson back to Balsameda. Kuhn with it, covered by Hoban. Drives toward the basket, kicks it out to Balsameda. Navina Jackson, she'll hoist up the three. No good. Rebounded by Martin. Hoban will slow it down there. Drive. Get it over to Wilkins off of her leg. Tip. As Justin's playing some great zone defense. Recovered by Sorensen to Martin with eight to shoot. She's going to drive. Fall away shot. No good. Rebounded by the Braves. stolen by the Dragons. Wilkins goes up. And she's fouled. Foul's going to be on Keller, her first of the night. Third team foul on the Braves, five on the Dragons. Little free throw rattles out. Got Messenger and Dominici checking into the game for the Braves. Looks like Juhas is getting ready to come back in. She's probably coming in from Wilkins, the shooter. Second free throw's no good. Rebounded by Keller. Over to Ewan, and she'll set up the offense, the senior guard. Messenger over to Dominici. It's over in the corner to Ewan. Eight to shoot. Took a look. Dominici will put it up. Off the rim, no good. Tipped out of bounds to the Dragon. Hugh has to check back into the game, replacing Wilkins. We're going to have Bauer, Juhas, Martin, Hoban, and Presley in the backcourt. Keller, Hume, Messenger, Washington, and Dominici for the Braves. Sorensen set up for three. Long rebound, tipped. Messenger will come up with it. Nice little spin move there. Goes up. No good, but she'll be going to the free throw line as Jan Thornton giving the instructions on, you know, kind of how to play it. Jordan Washington going to the line. Sophomore, senior for the Braves. First free throw's up. Nice free throw there. That one's no good, but Dominici will get the rebound. Back over to Jackson. Messenger will put it up for three off the front of the rim. No good. Great position by Sorensen there. Bauer comes down with the board. You can get a foul on Dominici. 14 foul on the Braves. Six on the Dragons. Crossover dribble by Hoban. Gets a screen by Juhas. Over to Martin, and she sets up for three off the back of the rim. No good. Tipped out by Juhas to Martin. Presley Sorensen gets it over to Juhas. Full shot clock again. Inside pass to Juhas. Knocked away. They're battling for it underneath. Dominici will come out with it. Over to Keller, and she'll bring it up for the Braves. 2:34 left here in the first half. 17-8 Dragons. Look at that defense that Hoban is playing. Much to the right of Coach JT and the crowd. They get it back over to Keller. She's going to drive up. No good. Tipped out of bounds to the Dragons. And Sonoma, Coach Thorpe, and all the players talked about before the season started how excited they were for this season, how much hard work they put in the offseason and conditioning and everything, and you can really see it on the court. Hoban get it over to Martin. Gets the screen. Back to Juhas. A beautiful play there. Juhas sets up the screen for Martin. She kicks it over to Bauer. Bauer hits the breaking Juhas for two. Sorensen on Keller. Martin will pick her up outside. Dragons are just handing them in, and there's an offensive foul. Little push off there. 19-8 Dragons, 1:41 left here in the first half. Wilkins will check back in and replace Martin. Sorensen, Juhas with it. Errant pass there. Out of bounds to the Braves. 1:30 left here in the first half. 19-8, Dragons on top. Megan Jackson with it over to Hughes. Picked up by Wilkins at full court pressure. It's over to Dominici, almost a walk, but it was tipped. Hewen will look at a three-point, gets it into Washington. Puts it up, no good, but she'll be shooting too. Calmly hits the first free throw. Misses the second one. Hoban will come out of it with the ball. And the drive, kick it over to Bauer. Back out to Hoban. Around the world to Sorensen. She'll drive, pick up the screen, gets it into Wilkins. A little off of her hand. Hewen will come up with the steal, and she'll bring it up herself. The Braves are running. 3-on-2 break. Puts it up and in, off the glass for two. Mary Hewen, the senior captain, 4-2 for the Braves. 19-11, Dragons in the lead. 45 seconds left in first half. Over to Juhas. Going to back it out to Sorensen. Over to Hoban. Both teams playing a pretty tough defense. One in a zone. One in a man-to-man. Hoban will drive to the basket, off the glass, no good. Gets her own rebound, no good again. Tipped away and stolen by Sorensen. Over to Wilkins, nice little fake there to Bauer. Juhas over to Sorensen. The shot clock is off, the Dragons can go for the last shot. Sorensen's gonna drive, lay it up with the left hand. Wilkins will get the board, gets hammered underneath. And they're going to call it in the act of shooting. Wilkins will hit both free throws. 4 seconds left. Dragons up by 10, 21-11. Navina Jackson, and that's going to be the end of the first half. Great defense by both squads out there. Sonoma, that man-to-man defense, really pressure holds Justin to 11 points, 21-11 at the half. Sonoma in the lead. We're going to go for the sponsors, and we'll come back and bring you the second half.
This broadcast is sponsored in part by
The Schoen Group, located in beautiful downtown Sonoma. The Schoen Group is affiliated with Sotheby's International Realty. Our goal is to be your realtor consultants and representatives for many generations to come. For information and guidance regarding Wine Country Real Estate, you may contact us at 707-933-1515 or visit schoengroup.com. Underwriting is provided by Sonoma Paint Center, located at 815 West Napa Street. For more information, you can go to sonomapaintcenter.com.
Being brought to you in part by Myers Financial, located at 670 West Napa Street, Suite C. For more information, you can go to myersfinancial.com.
Woo! Y'all know how, right? Let's go! Oh.
No masterpiece. Hey. 10 bad bads and they after me. Bang. One bad bad like a masterpiece. Looking for a dunk like an athlete. Big drip, what you call it? Big drip. Ice chain, pure water.
Ice, ice, ice.
You got the cab, can't afford it.
Cash.
You got the bad, but can't afford it.
She said, baby, let's go.
Yeah!
How is that? It's showing three. Yeah, it looks like it's got a couple still. So I'll come back in about 2 minutes still. Kill game. And we are back here live in Pfeiffer Gym. As you can see, there's several basketball games that have broken out here on the court. It's halftime with Sonoma up 21-11. Just intense pressure defense by both squads. Justin is more of a zone type defense, but they really extend it, and almost like a matchup zone. Sometimes they go man-to-man, full court pressure too. Sonoma is usually almost all the time full court pressure, and then man-to-man defense, just pounding the people, challenging passing lanes, the dribble, the shots, and the Dragons just having a good night so far. They hold their own destiny. If they can continue and take this contest tonight, they're guaranteed a share of the Vine Valley Athletic League. And if they win on Tuesday night at Casa Grande, they would be the outright champions. Still a whole bunch of scenarios left where you can have two or three teams tying for the league title. You got American Canyon and Casa Grande, Sonoma all battling it out. Sonoma's also looking for their first 20-win season since 2016-17. They had a nice run there, 2014 to 2017, where they had 20 or more victories in three straight seasons and three straight Sonoma County League titles. If they can come through and win the Vine Valley Athletic League title, it would be their first in the history of the league for the Lady Dragons. So a lot on the line tonight as the team's getting ready to start the second half. We do got a score from Petaluma after in the first quarter. Petaluma Trojans 16 and American Canyon 16. We'll see how that goes on through the night. Balsameda with it, picked up by King. Got the Dragons' normal starting lineup in here for most of the season. Martin, King, Hoban, Wilkins, and Sorensen. A steal by Sorensen behind the back dribble. Off of her leg. And they're going to talk it over and see if he saw it any better. Be honest, I didn't see it either, who it went off of. And they're going to change it up to the Dragons. Or no, to Justin. They're going to keep the call. Forgot that they switched sides of the court at halftime. Hewen will bring it up. Covered by Sorensen. Balsameda with it. Over to Washington. Get it over to Keller. Hands it off for Hewen. She's going to drive to the basket. Rolls out. Wilkins with a rebound. Over to Martin. Hoban's going to drive towards the basket. Stop. Spin. Put it up and in for two. 23-11 Dragons. Early here in the second half. Keller will walk it up for the Braves. He's kind of trapped in the corner there. Knocked away by Wilkins. Out of bounds. To the Dragons. Last touch by a Brave. Navina Jackson will check in for the Braves. Bringing a sophomore to replace a freshman. Got some senior leadership and a lot of young players on the Justin Siena team. You'll be seeing them for years. Wilkins. She'll recover the loose ball. And there's a walk. Kind of, she was going to pass to Sorensen there. Sorensen cut the other way. She tried to hold up with the ball and just kind of lost it. Balsameda would bring it up and beat the press. Picked up by Hoban. Going to drive towards the basket. Recovered by Martin, and she's going to bring it up to run. Knocked away by Balsameda, out of bounds to the Dragons. Both teams continuing here in the second half, playing really tough, pressure defense. Very intense on the court. A little bit too much sweat on the basketball. You say head coach does everything, huh? Does a great job that Jan Torp does, you know, not just on the court, but what she does with the students and the young ladies in guiding them, as you saw on senior night, how the seniors thanked her. Over to King. Gets it in to Wilkins. gets it back out to Martin. She'll set up shot for three off the rim. No good. Rebounded by Navina Jackson. The ball will be thrown out of bounds to the Dragons. And you can see the defense is just kind of rattling Justin's offense a little bit, keeping him, you know, out of sync. Sorensen will inbound it. Almost made the basket. Recovered by Hoban. Out to Martin. She's going to drive towards the basket. A little running shot. And will hit. 4-2. Nice pass there. Hewen will get it under the basket. She'll put it off the glass for two herself. Timeout, Justin, a 30-second timeout. Sonoma up 25-13. Yeah, you can see that the defense of the Dragons really been frustrating the offense of the Braves, and you know, he's gonna try to just settle down his team and draw up a little play here to try to get an easy shot when they get it. And Dragons are going to continue all night long, no matter who they put out on the court. They're going to bring that defense. ...25-13. 5.5 minutes left here in the third quarter. Dragons with the ball and the lead. Sorensen will swing it over to Hoban. Over to Martin. Picked up by Navina Jackson. Hoban will get it. Guarded by Hewing. Gets a screen. Over to Sorensen. Long three. Short. Rebounded by Wilkins. And they'll get it over to Hoban. Little pump fake. Over to Martin. And she's going to put up a three off the rim. No good. Rebounded by Washington. And Hewing will bring it up over to Balsameda. Covered by Sorensen. Just nowhere for Justin to go when they have the ball. Hewen will bring it in. The Balsameda. She's going to drive towards the basket. Put it up. No good. And you get kind of a bailout foul there. You know, you take it to the basket. Good things happen. And she should be shooting two free throws. Free throw, no good. Ball's battling on the court. Martin will come up with it over to Hoban. The Kings will get a screen, pass it to Martin. She'll bring it down. Hoban's in the corner, put it up, rattles out, rebounded by Navina Jackson. Well, it's made a picked up three quarter court by Hoban. When they get to set up their offense, it's always with 20 seconds or left because of the hounding defense. And he's asking for help, and he got the right call. Out of bounds off of Justin to the Dragons. That's one of the ones I actually saw as Bauer will check into the game. You're going to have Bauer, Wilkins, Juhasz, Hoban, and Sorensen. Cross-court pass to Wilkins. Back to Hoban. Takes a look over to Sorensen. The ball's knocked away, but like a pinball machine, goes over to Hoban, give a screen. Little give and go to Wilkins, and she's going to put it up. Might have been blocked, partially blocked. Dragons come up with it. Sorensen with the shot, rebounded by Messenger. Hewens looking to run. You're going to take it, a little jump stop, no good, but Washington came skying in there for a rebound. I think we got a jump ball, you know, held ball possession to the Dragons. Hewen's going to pick up Sorensen. Three-quarter court to get it over to Hoban. Cross court to Wilkins. She'll take a couple steps in, put it up off the glass. No good. Bowers battling for the rebound. Comes up to Sorensen. No good. Bowers with another rebound and throws it to someone she thought was underneath the basket that was cutting away. Got a little skeltered play here on the offense side for both teams. You know, you contribute that to the defense, just making you think you don't have as much time as you do to make a play. Full court pressure by the defense. Keller will get it over to Hewen. Dragons try to trap. Wilkins go for the steal. Good pressure once again. There's only 15 to shoot on the shot clock. Pass there. Gets off the hands. Nice move. Lays it up and in. Jordan Washington, sophomore senior for the Braves. Nice move and soft touch. 25-16, Dragons in the lead. Here in the third. 2:50 left. Bauer to Juhas. Over to Sorensen. She's got a wide open three. Long, a little bit short on the shot. Tipped away by the Braves to the Dragons. They're going to talk it over. They may change this up. I didn't really see it being tipped, but they're not going to. Might be the shot clock. Yep, shot clock goes back to 16. They reset the shot clock, but it wasn't a, you know, change of possession. Ball gets tipped. Juhas over to Sorensen. And Wilkins. And the bank is still open. Off the glass. Beautiful shot by Wilkins there. Keller with it. Picked up by Wilkins. 16 to shoot in the shot clock. With that pressured full court defense, you know, they don't get to start their offense. Jessen does till it's already 15 or so. They kick it out to Keller. 2 seconds to shoot. One. Shot clock violation. Great defense once again. That's the second time in this contest that Hannah Sparrow, one of the seniors for the Braves, will check in. Martin comes back in for Bauer. Bauer did a great job out there. She might not show up in the stat sheet all the time, but gives you valuable boards and the defense she plays. Super out there. Over to Wilkins. She'll drive. Gets it in to Juhas. Off the back, we're no good. Hewen will come down with it. She's kind of trapped. She'll back it out. Gets a screen. Going to get another screen. And she's going to drive straight to the hole. Well, that's like the fourth charge we've had in this game. Able to get position and take the charge. Got Balsameda and Messinger checking back in for the Braves. Sonoma still got Hoban, Sorensen, Juhas, Wilkins, and Martin. 27-16 late here in the third. Over to Hoban, swings it over to Martin, and she nails it again. 8 3-pointers the other night. That's her third of this game. 30-16. You're going to get a little hold foul on Sorensen there. And you're going to get some of those when you play the type of defense that the Dragons do. Going to kind of overcommit. It's only the first foul on Sorensen tonight. That's Keller with it, covered by Sorensen. Over to Balsameda, she'll kick it out to Messinger. Back to Keller, had a cutting Megan Jackson. She's gonna drive to the line, nice pass there. The shot's no good, rebounded by Martin. Dragons looking to finish off this quarter with some points here. Up 30-16, Martin again. No good, rebounded by Megan Jackson. Over to Balsameda. Megan Jackson with it, over to Keller. Messenger to Balsameda. No good. Battling for the rebound. It's going to go out of bounds to the Dragons. No shot clock. 20 seconds left in the quarter. Wilkins crossover dribble, kicks it out to Juhasz, to Sorensen, and she'll hoist up a long three, short. And that's going to be the end of the third quarter with the score of the Sonoma Valley High Dragons 30, Justin Siena Braves 16. We'll take a word from our sponsors and we'll be right back.
This broadcast is sponsored in part by
The Schoen Group, located in beautiful downtown Sonoma. The Schoen Group is affiliated with Sotheby's International Realty. Our goal is to be your realtor consultants and representatives for many generations to come. For information and guidance regarding Wine Country Real Estate, you may contact us at 707-933-1515 or visit schoengroup.com. Underwriting is provided by Sonoma Paint Center, located at 815 West Napa Street. For more information, you can go to sonomapaintcenter.com.
Being brought to you in part by Myers Financial, located at 670 West Napa Street, Suite C. For more information, you can go to myersfinancial.com.
Screen from Martin. Wilkins over to King. She's going to get it over to Martin. Over to Hoban. Five to shoot in the shot clock. Going to have to hoist it up. A little turnaround jump shot. No good. Rebounded by Washington. Hewins up to run for the Braves. She kind of carried that one. No call. Lays it up and in. Beautiful move to the basket. To the delight of the Justin crowd, 30-18, lead only 12 here in Pfeiffer. Both teams playing great defense. Balsameda on Hoban there. Bauer over to Martin, gets a screen from Wilkins. She's going to spin, put it up, no good, out of bounds. To the Braves. Taylor Stapello will check into the game, another sophomore point guard and shooting guard for the Braves. And Hewin, the senior captain, will bring it up for Justin. Covered by Hoban. Going to have a little push. Hoban. Trying to inbound it. Over to Stapello. Hewin with it. Gets it over to Messenger, covered by Martin. Gets it out at the top. Nice swing pass there. Stapello with it. 18 to shoot. Nice little move there for Messenger. Rebounded by Bauer. And Hoban will bring it up. Over to Martin. Bauer to Hoban, and the Dragons taking a little time off the clock, but you still got to get some good looks and hit some baskets. Nice in to Martin under the post. In and out, but Bauer will sky for the board. Martin will off the glass for two. Second chance points for the Dragons. 32-18. Washington over to Hewen, blocked by Wilkins, and they're going to call it a foul in the act of shooting. As Wilkins say, what did I do? And I know I committed many fouls when I used to play, and didn't think I committed one. Hewen to the line. Sorensen replaces Kane. Keller will replace Messenger. Second free throw is up, no good. Rebounded by Wilkins. Over to Hoban. Screen from Martin, give and go. Martin will put it up, no good. Keller skied for that rebound, comes down with it, and will get fouled. It's going to be on Hoban, her third foul. 15th foul already on the Dragons, only one for Justin. Hewen will bring it up, gets it over in the corner. Nice little pump fake there, misses the shot. Wilkins will gather the rebound, and Hoban will bring it up. As Justin gets back in numbers, over to Wilkins. Little spin move, no good. Rebounded by Washington. Hewen will bring it up. They're trying to trap her in the corner. Over to Washington. There's a three-point attempt, no good. Tipped away by Martin, out of bounds to the Braves. Megan Jackson will check in for Justin, replacing Stoppello. Keller guarded by Bauer. He's going to move there back to Keller. Took a shot. Hewen's going to launch up the three. No good. Martin will sky for the board. A little over 4 minutes left. Dragons up by 14, 32-18, and Sorensen will slow it up, covered by Hewen. Over to Hoban, takes a look. She'll drive, back her player down, spin, kick it out to Sorensen. Back to Hoban with seven. Wilkins, she's going to drive towards the basket, kick it out to Sorensen. She's going to put it up and banks it in for three. Big shot there for the Dragons. Milk the clock all the way down. Hit a big three. Dragons kind of backing off of the pressure just a tad, but just making them take time. And there's a step on the out-of-bounds lines. Another turnover to the Dragons. Sophia Dominici will check in for Justin. She's going to replace Bolak, as Justin and Sonoma getting a lot of their players in the contest. Nice little screen. Sorensen's going to drive towards the basket, lay it up, but a big block there. I think Hewen got the hand in there and blocked it. A little over 3 minutes, Sonoma with the ball in the lead. Martin's going to take a long three, no good. Rebounded by Washington, but knocked away, but out of bounds to the Braves.
Good hustle,
You got both teams just giving it all on the court tonight. Snowman's had a little more offensive firepower. Both teams tenacious defense. Over to Dominici. Going to kick it out to Balsameda, and she's going to put up a three, no good. Tipped, and Sorensen will come down with it. Two on three break. A little fancy dribbling there over to Hoban. She's going to drive down the hole, loses the handle. Wilkins will go down. Tied possession. Nice hustle there to get that, tie up that loose ball, and possession arrows to the Dragons. Juhasz will check back in, replacing Wilkins. Yeah, Navina Jackson checking in for the Braves, along with Hannah Spear and Taylor Stapello. 2:44 left here in Pfeiffer. Bauer pump fake. Tipped away. Dominici with the pass deflection there. 15 to shoot for the Dragons. I guess time to thank our sponsors, Sonoma Paint Center, the Schoen Group, and Myers Financial. The shot's no good. Tip. Sorensen's going to get the rebound over to Hoban. Oh, a little behind the back. Razzle dazzle. DeMartin, no good. Juhasz with the rebound. Up and in for two. 37-18. Just over 2 minutes left. Keller will bring it up for the Braves. Only a freshman out there. Played a solid game for the Braves. Dominici over to Navina Jackson. Stapello with it. Back to Navina Jackson. Got a lot of young players on this Braves squad. Shot put up. Bauer with the block. Sorensen will come down with it. Bauer's going to take it to the basket. Stop. Put it up. No good. Juhasz with the hold. 16 foul on the Dragons. Justin will be inbounding it. One more, and they'll be shooting one-on-one. King checking back into the game, replacing Bauer. Hold there. Got the freshman, number 5, Alice Turner, checking in for the Dragons, and also number 3, Lexi Medeiros, replacing Martin. Get a big hand. And Hoban. Dominici, big ovation for Martin. Rebounded by Turner. Dragons will bring it up. 1:22 left. Nice little pass to Madero. She's going to put it up. No good. Tipped away by Juhasz. Out of bounds to the Braves. Jesslyn Bolak checks into the game for the Braves, replacing Keller. Dominici to Navina Jackson. Kick it back to Navina. She's going to put it up for three. Off the rim, no good. Rebounded by Juhasz. Stolen away by Spare. It's going to be an over and back violation. It's a good ball because she already stepped across the court. Then she jumped up in the air. Here's a hand for Juhasz, one of the Sonoma Valley seniors. Replaced by Destiny Tapia, a junior forward for the Dragons. Also into the game, Mia Lucchetti. Capella with it. Going to go out of bounds to the Braves. This time I'd like to thank our crew tonight. Juan, the master of all trades, doing the filming and the controls. Great job, Juan. Yep. The clock went up. Scoreboards are out. And they're back on. 37 seconds left. Someone kicked the cord out. Nice inbound play there. And Spare will get the two. Ricchetti will bring it up for the Dragons. And a drive towards the basket. Gets stolen away. Get a reach and foul on Medeiros. Capello will be shooting 1-1. Rattles the first one in. Turner will come down with that rebound to the Dragons. Medeiros with it. Over to Lucchetti. Swings it over to Amorino. She'll launch up a three. Just in and out. Esper will come up with the board. And that's the ball game here on Senior Night. Sonoma Valley 37. Justin Siena 21. Just a great defensive effort. Some big threes from Martin and Presley. Good inside game by Wilkins and Juhas. Everybody on the court played great defense for both sides. Sonoma will improve their record to 9-2 and have at least a share of the Vine Valley Athletic League title, 20-5 on the season. The last time they've had 20 wins was in 2016-17, and it's off to Casa Grande on Tuesday night. Either got a share of the title. If they beat the Gauchos, they will be Vine Valley Athletic League champions outright. So I'd like to thank our sponsors, Sonoma Paint Center, Myers Financial, and the Schoen Group, everyone at KSBY. It's always a great day to be a Dragon. Good night.
This broadcast is sponsored in part by
the Schoen Group, located in beautiful downtown Sonoma. The Schoen Group is affiliated with Sotheby's International Realty. Our goal is to be your realtor consultants and representatives for many generations to come. For information and guidance regarding Wine Country Real Estate, you may contact us at 707-933-1515 or visit schoengroup.com. Underwriting is provided by Sonoma Paint Center, located at 815 West Napa Street. For more information, you can go to sonomapaintcenter.com.
Being brought to you in part by Myers Financial, located at 670 West Napa Street, Suite C. For more information, you can go to myersfinancial.com.